Joining me right now is New York Times investigative reporter, author of Salt, Sugar, Fat. His name is Michael Moss. Good morning and welcome to the PIX11 Morning News. Michael, thank you for joining us.
Good morning to you. Thanks for having me.
Michael, you saw right there we have a slight obsession. Mainly it's me pushing my politics and other people around here. So you spent your career infiltrating the food industry. I'm so excited to talk to you because how the heck is it possible that this spice sparked a $1 billion industry?
Yeah. It's incredible. I mean, I've crawled through the underbelly of this industry for like 10 years, and there's kind of nothing more revealing than the way that they flood the grocery stores and fast food restaurants this time of year with pumpkin spice, mm-hmm. right? So when we cook, right, we use pumpkin or canned pumpkin just as well as these incredible spices, right? Cinnamon, allspice, nutmeg, ginger. Yeah. You can tell I want my own cooking show sometime. But the companies have chemical laboratories called flavor houses.
Yeah.
And they just happen to be concentrated in the New Jersey corridor from Mahwah down to New Brunswick. They're pretty secretive places, but I managed to get one of them to let me inside to explain to them how they make pumpkin spice.
Yeah, and so you went inside and I was fascinated by this because I was watching a video where you talked about lactones, ketones, cyclotones, vanillin, pyrazines, all things. I'm like, yeah. I thought it was cinnamon, nutmeg, and clove.
No, for various reasons, they cannot use the real spices that we use, right? So they have machinery there where they can slide a pie into it and it will give them the full spectrum of chemical compounds in that pie. And then they walk to the shelf, and this is like a vast mm-hmm. room of laboratory glassware like I have in front of me, and they will pull off the chemicals that they think will mimic the flavor notes in those spices. So as you mentioned, they have cyclotones, right? This mimics the crust, the toasted maple-like brown flavor that's on top of the pie. They have sulfurol in the filling, right?
Yummy.
This still tastes like custardy, eggy caramel. They have vanillin, right? Which shouldn't be confused with real vanilla. This is an aldehyde, creamy, sweet. Pyrazines, I think you mentioned.
Yeah.
This is my favorite part of the pie. It's the very top of the pie.
Oh, yeah.
That crust that gets a little brown. It's like nutty, caramel tasting. And at the end of the day, oh, I should mention this one too. I couldn't even put it on my little picnic.
Oh my goodness.
Plate. It's so big.
Delta.
This is another filling, creamy, buttery. And for some of the pumpkin spice in their products, they're using as many as 80.
Yeah, wow. But let me ask you this, because
people
kind of caught on, right? And when they look at a label, they're like, I don't want to eat this because I don't even know what a cyclotone is. So then like Pop-Tarts, for example, started putting actual pumpkin in or pumpkin flavor, right? Is this accurate?
Yeah. I've got the things got a little tricky for them because we started reading the labels and like, who wants to see this on the label of their food? So the companies actually started adding some real spices, but there's an out for them because if they say natural flavor or even artificial flavor, they can still pump in those chemical compounds to enhance the flavor of the real spices that they
and
might
here's,
be
at. And here's the thing, right? It's all because of this thing called LTO, limited time offer, right?
Exactly. It's all about sort of driving emotions. And you can ask like, why pumpkin and not zucchini, for example? Well, pumpkin evokes an emotion in us warm and fuzzy, right?
Yes.
But as you mentioned, LTO, I mean, think about a limited time offer. It gets the brain excited about rushing to the store and getting something because it's not going to be there very long.
That's why I come
and
out
it's
earlier.
A little like Thanksgiving or holiday dinners where your uncle you never see all year comes to visit. That's like a little special exciting.
Yeah.
And the companies know how to tap those emotions in us as well as they know how to mimic the chemicals and real ingredients.
And it comes out earlier every year because you just make more money off of it, right? It's more of a limited time offer. Real quick, we're almost out of time. Michael, I could talk to you all day because I just love talking to you and your props. What is, because I, by the way, they don't believe me around here. I think I found pumpkin long before it became a thing. You're on to what is the next pumpkin spice?
Got it right here for you. Maple.
Maple. But is this harder?
Yes.
Because
nope.
Maple syrup is a little expensive.
Oh, it's very expensive. You're not going to find any maple in many of these products, but you're going to see the chemical compound that mimics maple. So, you know, bon appetit.
That's for the next segment. Michael Moss, you are welcome back here anytime. You're fascinating. Your book is just one heck of a book, too. Thank you so much.
I appreciate that.